Memorial Day, numbers by the year 1971 to 2022. The finished product of all finished products. The very last numbers by the year series, excluding any chance of doing Veterans Day numbers by the year, Columbus Day numbers by the year, Mother's Day numbers by the year, and Father's Day numbers by the year. Or any other, quote-unquote, numbers by the year idea I would have had, but I just didn't give a shit about it, and it wasn't something that mattered enough to me to do. So, let's do this introduction a little differently from all the others. Episode 1, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Episode 2, the 1980s. Episode 3, the 1990s. Episode 4, the 2000s. Episode 5, the 2010s. Episode 6, the 2020s so far. And finally, Episode 7, the series rant and finale. Hi everybody, I am your host, Brian Mullins the Fox, and welcome to Memorial Day numbers by the year, 1971 to 2022. This is the first episode, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Before we get into the history of this holiday, to finish off this entire Numbers by the Year collection, let's set the statistical perimeters on what I do and do not have to cover. What I will cover in this series, number 1, the total number of travelers for each year starting from 2006 and finishing off in 2022, for the sake of data availability. Number 2, the total amount of accidents for each year for Memorial Day, based on data or statistical availability for each represented year. Number 3, the history of Memorial Day as a federal holiday in America. Number 4, Memorial Day accident statistics. Number 5, the date that each Memorial Day for each year lands on. Number 6, what separates Memorial Day from all other holidays when it comes to food consumption and waste. Number 7, the future of my channels, both Brian Mullins the Fox and Brian Mullins the Fox 2, after the Numbers by the Year collection is complete and obsolete as a format. The history of Memorial Day as a federal holiday. It was originally introduced and established in 1868, 3 years after the Civil War ended, as quote-unquote Decoration Day, to honor both Confederate and Union soldiers, but wasn't a federal holiday until 1971, the same year the U.S. abandoned the Golden Standard. From 1868 to 1970, within the span of 102 years, it was observed on May 30th and May 30th alone. But in 1971, that all changed by making Memorial Day beyond the last Monday of May. In 1968, Congress passed the Uniform Monday Holiday Act, which made Memorial Day a federal holiday that always landed on the last Monday of May, starting in 1971. And now let's get into the date for each year that Memorial Day lands on in the 1970s. 1971, May 31st. 1972, May 29th. 1973, May 28th. 1974, May 27th. 1975, May 26th. 1976, May 31st. 1977, May 30th, 1978, May 29th, 1979, May 28th, and for 1980, May 26th. In the next episode, which will all be in one cluster, depending on chapter timestamps, we'll get into the 1980s and some more statistics surrounding car accidents and the characteristics of such, percentages, etc. I'm Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out. Memorial Day, numbers by the year, 1971 to 2022. The finished product of all finished products. The very last numbers by the year series, excluding any chance of doing Veterans Day numbers by the year, Columbus Day numbers by the year, Mother's Day numbers by the year, and Father's Day numbers by the year. Or any other, quote-unquote, numbers by the year idea I would have had, but I just didn't give a shit about it, and it wasn't something that mattered enough to me to do. So, let's do this introduction a little differently from all the others. Episode 1, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Episode 2, the 1980s. Episode 3, the 1990s. Episode 4, the 2000s. Episode 5, the 2010s. Episode 6, the 2020s so far. And finally, Episode 7, the series rant and finale. Hello, everybody. I am Brian Mullins the Fox, your delightful host. Welcome to Episode 2 of Memorial Day Numbers by the Year, 1971 to 2022. We are going to cover the 1980s. Let's start off with the date for each year that Memorial Day landed on. 1981, May 25th. 1982, May 31st. 1983, May 30th. 1984, May 28th. 1985, May 27th. 1986, May 26th. 1987, May 25th. 1988, May 30th. 1989, May 29th. And for 1990, May 28th. Now let's get into motor fatalities, meaning that it continues all the way up to Episode 5. According to BMC research notes, here are the characteristics of individuals involved in fatal crashes during the Memorial Day weekends from 1981 to 2016. For each episode, we're only going to read the stats that represent each decade. In this case, the 1980s. Now, this is going to be very complex. Let's get into year groups. From 1981 to 1985, there were a total of 2,299 individual fatal crashes, which makes 15% of the overall fatal crashes, which is the same for comparison days. From 1986 to 1990, there were a total of 2,466, which makes 16% of the overall amount of fatal crashes during the Memorial Day time period of analysis, which is the same percentage as comparison days. We'll get into region after we've analyzed all the numbers in this whole table. Now let's get on to table 2, odds ratio and 95% confidence interval for motor vehicle fatalities during Memorial Day weekends. Let's get into the year groups, shall we? And start off with between 1981 and 1985, the odds ratio was 1.07%. And the 95% confidence interval was 1.01 and 1.13. And for 1986 to 1990, the odds ratio was 1.08. And the 95% confidence interval was 1.02 and 1.15. The p-value for 1981 to 1985 is 0.030. And for the second group, 1986 to 1990, it's 0.007. Alright, that will do for this episode of Memorial Day Numbers by the Year, 1971 to 2022. I've been your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out. See you then. Memorial Day, Numbers by the Year, 1971 to 2022. The finished product of all finished products. The very last Numbers by the Year series. Excluding any chance of doing Veterans Day Numbers by the Year, Columbus Day Numbers by the Year, Mother's Day Numbers by the Year, and Father's Day Numbers by the Year. Or any other, quote-unquote, Numbers by the Year idea I would have had, but I just didn't give a shit about it, and it wasn't something that mattered enough to me to do. So, let's do this introduction a little differently from all the others. Episode 1, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Episode 2, the 1980s. Episode 3, the 1990s. Episode 4, the 2000s. Episode 5, the 2010s. Episode 6, the 2020s so far. And finally, Episode 7, the series rant and finale. Hello, everybody. I am your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox, Welcome to episode 3 of Memorial Day Numbers by the Year 1971 to 2022. We're going to be covering the 1990s. Let's start with the dates for each year that Memorial Day landed on. 1991, May 27th, 1992, May 25th, 1993, May 31st, 1994, May 30th, 1995, May 29th, 1996, May 27th, 1997, May 26th, 1998, May 25th, 1999, May 31st, and for 2000, May 29th. Let's continue with fatal motor accidents. For 1991 to 1995, there were a total of 2,079 fatal car accidents during the Memorial Day weekend in total, which makes up 14% of the total amount of fatal car crashes in comparison to comparison days, which shares the same percentage. For 1996 to 2000, it went a little up with a total of 2,090 fatal car crashes. In comparison days, there were about 3,871 fatal car crashes. I hope you understand that the data and statistics may seem more complex than I'm making it out to be. I'm trying to dumb it down as easily as humanly possible. Now let's get back to Table 2, odds ratio and 95% confidence interval for motor vehicle fatalities during Memorial Day weekends. For 1991 to 1995, the odds ratio was 1.08, and the 95% confidence interval for 1991 to 1995 was 1.01 and 1.14. And for 1996 to 2000, the odds ratio was 1.08, the same as between 1991 and 1995. The 95% confidence interval for 1996 to 2000 was 1.02 and 1.15. And that will do it for this episode of Memorial Day Numbers by the Year. I've been your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out. See you in the next episode. Memorial Day, numbers by the year, 1971 to 2022. The finished product of all finished products. The very last numbers by the year series. Excluding any chance of doing Veterans Day numbers by the year, Columbus Day numbers by the year, Mother's Day numbers by the year, and Father's Day numbers by the year. Or any other quote-unquote numbers by the year idea I would have had, but I just didn't give a shit about it, and it wasn't something that mattered enough to me to do. So, let's do this introduction a little differently from all the others. Episode 1, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Episode 2, the 1980s. Episode 3, the 1990s. Episode 4, the 2000s. Episode 5, the 2010s. Episode 6, the 2020s so far. And finally, Episode 7, the series rant and finale. Hello, everybody. I'm your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox, and welcome to Memorial Day Numbers by the Year 1971 to 2022. We're in Episode 4 now, and we're going to be handling and covering the 2000s. We're almost there, folks. Get ready. Let's start off with the date that each Memorial Day for each year landed on. 2001, May 28th. 2002, May 27th. 2003, May 26th. 2004, May 31st. 2005, May 30th. 2006, May 29th. 2007, May 28th. 2008, May 26th. 2009, May 25th. And for 2010, May 31st. Now let's get into the total amount of travelers for each year for Memorial Day, starting in 2006. According to Statista, 2006, 36 million Americans. 2007, 35.3 million Americans. 2008, 31.6 million Americans. 2009, 30.5 million Americans. And for 2010, 34.8 million Americans. We will continue this in the next episode. For 2001 to 2005, there were a total of 2,238 fatal motor crashes, which makes up for 15% in comparison to the 4,019 fatal motor crashes overall, with 14%. And for 2006 to 2010, 1,998 fatal motor accidents, which makes up 13% in comparison to the comparison days, with a total of 3,614 fatal motor accidents overall. And we'll finish this one in the next episode, and then get to the region in that episode. Now let's move on to something more important, Table 2. For 2001 to 2005, the odds ratio was 1.11, just as it was in 2006 to 2010. For 2001 to 2005, the 95% confidence interval was 1.05 and 1.18. And for 2006 to 2010, the 95% confidence interval was 1.04 and 1.18. And that will do for episode 4 of Memorial Day Numbers by the Year. Tune in next episode as we will tackle and cover the last full decade in this series, the 2010s. And oh, will it be a sight to behold? Memorial Day, Numbers by the Year, 1971 to 2022. The finished product of all finished products. The very last Numbers by the Year series. Excluding any chance of doing Veterans Day Numbers by the Year, Columbus Day Numbers by the Year, Mother's Day Numbers by the Year, and Father's Day Numbers by the Year. Or any other, quote-unquote, Numbers by the Year idea I would have had, but I just didn't give a shit about it, and it wasn't something that mattered enough to me to do. So, let's do this introduction a little differently from all the others. Episode 1, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Episode 2, the 1980s. Episode 3, the 1990s. Episode 4, the 2000s. Episode 5, the 2010s. Episode 6, the 2020s so far. And finally, Episode 7, the series rant and finale. Hello everybody, I am your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox. Welcome to Episode 5 of Memorial Day Numbers by the Year 1971 to 2022. Let's cover the dates for each year that Memorial Day landed on in the 2010s. 2011, May 30th. 2012, May 28th. 2013, May 27th. 2014, May 26th. 2015, May 25th. 2016, May 30th. 2017, May 29th. 2018, May 28th. 2019, May 27th. And for 2020, May 25th. Now let's get into the number of Memorial Day travelers in the United States from 2006 to 2022 in millions, but starting with 2011 in this episode. 2011, 34.3 million Americans. 2012, 35.1 million Americans. 2013, 35.5 million Americans. 2014, 35.5 million Americans.
2015, 37.38 million Americans.
2016, 38.25 million Americans. 2017, 39.26 million Americans. 2018, 41.5 million Americans. 2019, 42.75 million Americans. And for 2020, 23.1 million Americans. The reason for the great decline in Memorial Day travelers is simply due to the COVID-19 outbreak and pandemic. For 2011 to 2016, there were a total of 2,122 fatal crashes during the Memorial Day weekends, which makes up 14% of the comparison days, with 3,827 fatal crashes with the same percentage. Let's get into age. the fatal crashes involving those under the age of 18 during the Memorial Day holiday weekend was 1,885, 12% of the total amount of fatal crashes, covering the 35 years the statistics table analyzes. For those between 18 to 64 years old, when it comes to these fatal crashes, it makes up a total of 77%, or 11,745 fatal crashes. And for those above the age of 65, 1,662 of them, or 11% of the fatal crashes. In comparison days, for those who are under the age of 18, 3,425 fatal car crashes, which makes up 12% of the comparison days' amounts of total fatal crashes. 18 to 64, 76% with 21,215, and for older than 65, 12% or 3,425. Now let's move on to sex. 71% for both holiday period and comparison days make up the biggest bulk in the death toll, while females are subdominant with a shared 29% of the death toll when it comes to fatal crashes during Memorial Day weekends. Over the past 35 years between 1981 to 2016, the unknown or not reported ones for Memorial Day holiday period, there were 8 that were unreported in comparison to 31 that are unreported in the comparison days. And here are the rest of the stats here as they are shown on screen, including the region. Now here comes the fun part, statistics-wise. According to a GetJerry.com study written and published by Henry Honig, a data journalist, on May 25th, 2022, here are all the statistics surrounding Memorial Day between 2011 and 2020. Like fatalities per 100,000 people, risk rises as the sun falls, with the deadliest hour being the 20th hour. Fatalities by day of week, the deadliest being Saturday. The states with the highest death tolls, the highest being Texas. The states with the most fatalities per capita, the state with the most being West Virginia. Cities with the most crash fatalities, the city with the most being Houston. Memorial Day weekend fatalities by county. The one with the most fatalities is Harris County in Houston, Texas. Like deaths per capita in counties with populations above 1 million. Three counties share a tie of 0.2 per 100,000 people. Palm Beach County in Florida, St. Louis County in Missouri, and Fresno County in California. Fatality rates in medium-sized counties, the most being in the St. Tammany Parish, or the New Orleans metro area in Louisiana, with a staggering 1.51 per 100,000. And that is about it when it came to statistics. So overall, we're going to just finish off the 2020s in the next episode, which won't be very long at all. I am Brian Mullins, the Fox, your delightful host, signing out. Memorial Day, numbers by the year, 1971 to 2022. The finished product of all finished products. The very last numbers by the year series, excluding any chance of doing Veterans Day numbers by the year, Columbus Day numbers by the year, Mother's Day numbers by the year, and Father's Day numbers by the year. Or any other quote-unquote numbers by the year idea I would have had, but I just didn't give a shit about it, and it wasn't something that mattered enough to me to do. So, let's do this introduction a little differently from all the others. Episode 1, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Episode 2, the 1980s. Episode 3, the 1990s. Episode 4, the 2000s. Episode 5, the 2010s. Episode 6, the 2020s so far. And finally, Episode 7, the series rant and finale. Hello, everybody. I am your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox. And welcome to Episode 6 of Memorial Day, Numbers by the Year, 1971 to 2022. Let's get straight into the dates for each year that Memorial Day landed on for 2021 and 2022. 2021, May 31st, and for 2022, May 30th. let's go straight into the number of Memorial Day travelers in the United States from 2006 to 2022 in millions, according to Statista. 2021, 37.1 million Americans. And for 2022, 39.2 million Americans. So before I end this episode, I just want to say, before the rant, we've been through an amazing journey throughout the past several months, and throughout this entire series along with it. I'm glad I was able to record this all at once, in one sitting, in one night. Maybe I can make this into a whole video one of these days. Soon enough, by the time this premieres, you'll be able to see it and enjoy it with your friends. So before I sign out, I want to thank you all for watching. Hit that like button, share this video, and subscribe. I'm your host, Brian Mullins the Fox, signing out. See you in the rant episode and series finale. Bye. Memorial Day. Numbers by the year. 1971 to 2022. The finished product of all finished products. The very last Numbers by the Year series. Excluding any chance of doing Veterans Day Numbers by the Year, Columbus Day Numbers by the Year, Mother's Day Numbers by the Year, and Father's Day Numbers by the Year. Or any other quote-unquote Numbers by the Year idea I would have had, but I just didn't give a shit about it, and it wasn't something that mattered enough to me to do. So, let's do this introduction a little differently from all the others. Episode 1, Statistical Perimeters and the 1970s. Episode 2, the 1980s. Episode 3, the 1990s. Episode 4, the 2000s. Episode 5, the 2010s. Episode 6, the 2020s so far. And finally, Episode 7, the series rant and finale. Hello, everybody. I'm your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox. And before I end this series with Episode 7 of Memorial Day, Numbers by the Year 1971 to 2022, I just want to go off on a rant. All right? I am sick and fucking tired of this goddamn tedious format. I know it's supposed to inform the audience, and I know that it's supposed to cover pretty much anything you can with each holiday. I'm not gonna cover every single last tiny little thing, because it will just be useless itself. And I will hopefully add on to a lot of these statistics with more follow-up videos for Thanksgiving. I already covered Christmas, and a couple others that aren't really that important. But overall, it's been a great, and I mean great, fucking run between June 12th, 2022, and the day that I'm recording this, January 29th, 2023, and by the time this premieres, which is sometime in April. Before I sign off and put you guys through a series montage, I want to again thank you all for watching, share this shit around before I end the series, and thanks for being there for me when I need you all most when it comes to my dying channels. One of these days, my main furry channel may no longer have above or at 10,000 subscribers. It's gonna be less, but it just depends. It's just a matter of when. The future for my channels varies a lot, and I'm not making any absolute predictions or anything like that. It wouldn't matter if that I would be making predictions sometime later. It's just gonna happen. I don't give that much of a shit. And with that being said, I am your host. I have been your delightful host, Brian Mullins the Fox, signing off. Enjoy the montage.
There will be many other nights like this, and I'll be standing here with someone new. There will be other songs to sing, another fall, another spring, but there will another you. There will be other lips that I may kiss, but they won't thrill me like yours used to do. Yes, I may dream a million dreams, but how can they come true? But how?